Hi, I'm Jerry Hightower, and as you can probably tell by this very snappy outfit, I'm a park ranger, and I work right here at the Chattahoochee River National Recreation Area. And my job is to provide education and programming and to share all the joys and wonder that is the Chattahoochee River Corridor. It's absolutely fantastic. The Chattahoochee River National Recreation Area is 48 miles of the beautiful Chattahoochee River. It starts at the base of Buford Dam at Lake Lanier, and it winds down all the way to and actually into the city limits of Atlanta. And along that 48 miles, there are 16 different land units. And in these land units, there are beautiful hiking trails. And this area is designed to protect the natural and the historic and the archaeological values of this 48 miles of the Chattahoochee River Corridor. Now, the Chattahoochee River starts high in the North Georgia Mountains. And as that water bubbles and seeps out of that sand and gravel, it begins its journey down that steep mountainside. And very quickly, it gains more waters. Little springs and tiny tributaries add their water to it. And soon, it becomes a rip-roaring, crashing mountain stream. And it goes through the city of Atlanta and continues on down. And it then suddenly turns south. And at that point, it becomes the boundary between the state of Alabama and the state of Georgia. And it winds its way down, and suddenly the waters of the Flint River come in to join the Chattahoochee River, and it forms Lake Seminole. When it comes out of Lake Seminole, it's now in Florida, and it becomes the Apalachicola River. All up and down the Chattahoochee River in the national park, you'll see these beautiful forests. The Chattahoochee River is a good example of a freshwater ecosystem because it is fed by rain. Now, don't drink our rainwater. It's really, really dirty. But when it falls in the forest, 60% of that rain is caught in the canopy and it evaporates right back up in the atmosphere. Now, the remaining 40% is now smaller drops, and it's falling down to the forest floor slower than when it originally started. And then on the forest floor, all the leaf litter and the pine straw grabs all that water and it soaks it up just like a sponge. And then gravity begins to pull all that water underground, downhill, into little streams that all flow into the Chattahoochee River. The Chattahoochee River is extremely important to the state of Georgia. It provides drinking water to more than one-third of the citizens, and yet it is the smallest watershed in all of the United States serving this many people. And so every single person along the Chattahoochee River affects that river, and their actions or inactions are going to determine whether we have a healthy, clean river or not. It's really important that people realize that water just doesn't come out of the faucet. It comes from rivers and lakes and streams, and sometimes wells drilled deep into the earth. So we want to know where our water comes from so we can protect those sources and make sure that water stays clean and healthy. Well, there's lots you can do to conserve water. Some of it's very simple. When you're brushing your teeth, turn the water off while you brush. Take short showers. Always wash your dishes with the dishwasher because that uses a lot less water. Be careful about watering the lawn. Maybe it doesn't need watering at all. And so we need to be very careful with how we use water and keep in mind that we want to conserve it all the time. We always have to remember, this is all the water we're ever going to have. We never can make more water molecules. Why? The water we're drinking today is the same water the dinosaurs used. We just keep using it over and over again. And so it's critically important that we take care of this precious resource.